my name is Kathy. Welcome back to my channel. Today I've prepared a sequence for you to ease sciatic pain. If you are not experiencing sciatic pain, that's okay. This would be a great sequence for a simple morning stretch, something that's relaxing, something that's soothing, or something to wind down after long days of work. Okay, so in the video, I will show you two particular tests for you to see if you do have sciatic pain, and if you are experiencing any form of pain, I would definitely recommend going to see a doctor first to see or consult a health professional nearest to you to see if these particular stretches are necessarily working out for you or they're good for you, because there are many different causes of sciatic pain, and it's important to know what kind of cause is creating that pain. It could be a bulging disc, a herniated disc, it could be a piriformis muscle related kind of pain. So I would definitely recommend doing that before embarking on this video. Today we're going to start on our back, but before that I would like to show you two tests, two very simple tests that you can always do at your at home to figure out whether you might be experiencing sciatic nerve pain. So sciatic nerve is one of the biggest nerves that run down all the way down our leg. And it when the pain that you will experience is oftentimes a pins and needles or a sharp tingling sensation that can be quite painful doing certain postures. So the first test I'm going to show you is if you were to lie all the way down onto your back and with one leg stretched out, and then when you raise one of the legs up, okay, you might immediately feel a pain running all the way down this particular leg. So if this is something you're experiencing right now, you would want to bring it back down a little lower and see whether or not you still experience that pain on the outside of that leg. Okay? So maybe you don't have that range of motion, maybe you do. So that's the first test. Then the second test is also to check whether you have this thing called the piriformis syndrome. For a lot of people, they say that this is different from sciatic pain, only because it's actually only running down the leg and you don't feel the sensation in the lower back. So one way from here, all you have to do is to sort of lie on the left side of your body. Lie on the left side of your body. And the left side of your body, and if you bring that top knee over, when you turn the knee in towards the midline, feel a sharp pain along here, chances are you might have this thing called the piriformis syndrome, which is very similar to sciatic nerve pain. Another way of checking it is to come back onto your back, you know, okay. If I were to bring the leg all the way up, and if I were to turn out to the side, you might feel like, okay, this might be a sense of relief. And if you were to turn it into the midline, immediately you might feel a pinching sensation all the way down here. Okay? So these are two very simple tests you can try out at home just to figure out whether or not you might be experiencing this kind of pain. And if you are, always consult a health professional or a doctor that is near you so you can figure it out. And without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so for today's practice, all you will need is a strap, two blocks, and maybe a bolster. Of course, if you don't have a bolster, any kind of pillow will do. If you don't have blocks, any kind of books will do, and maybe a tie, a towel, if you don't have a strap. Okay, so today we're gonna start all the way onto our backs. We're gonna knock our knees together with our feet mat distance apart. You can have your hands on your belly. And we're just going to take a few breaths in and out to find our space on our mat before we start our practice today. And as you start closing the eyes, relaxing the jaw, your facial muscles, including your back muscles, allow yourself to start becoming a little more aware in how you're breathing. And as you relax your eyes, your facial muscles, your back muscles, start tuning in towards your breath. It's just observing either the rise and fall or the expansion. And melting of the chest. Without manipulating your breath, just observing how it moves as you're lying down here today. Notice how long or how short your inhalations are. Whether it's any different from your exhalation. Notice whether you're allowing yourself to completely live out each breath cycle before you take in the next. Or whether you take the next breath in even before you fully emptied out your lungs. Notice the quality of your breath. Is it long? Is it short? Is it deep? Or is it shallow? Without forming any particular judgment on what kind of breath it should be, just allow yourself to observe. Taking a full breath in and a full breath out. So now we're going to start off by placing the right foot on the ground. We're going to start with the left leg. So if you can't interlace the fingers and you're struggling to bring that knee in, option is to take a strap, strapping along your kneecap or your shin. And then just relaxing the shoulders and creating a little bit of pressure by drawing that left knee in. If you can do it without a strap, interlace your fingers and just lightly draw that left knee in, slowly in towards the chest. So we're going to incorporate this thing called the PNF stretching. What you want to do is to create resistance first before you allow it to relax further. It really helps with developing flexibility, I would say, in a very simple way. So what I'm going to get you to do is to take a full breath in first and a full breath out. Now, actively you're going to push the knee in towards the palms as much as you can, creating a lot of resistance. So lifting the knee towards the interlace of the fingers, and the interlace of the fingers is trying to push it down. You're going to hold it here for about 10 seconds. Breathe, don't hold your breath. Keep pushing the knee up in towards the fingers, fingers trying to push it back down, creating a lot of resistance in your quadricep. 3, 2, and 1, relax, pull that left knee in. Notice the sensation in that left leg. You can go ahead and repeat this a few times, or just hold on to this left knee wherever it is. And just relax. Each out breath may be bringing that knee a little closer in towards the chest. switch sides. Left knee on the ground, left foot on the ground. So left foot on the ground, bringing the right knee in towards the chest. Use a strap if you need to. Take a full breath in. And a full breath out. Again, 10 seconds. Push the knee into the interlace of the hands. Keep pushing, and the hands try to press the knee down. Really contracting at the quadriceps, creating a lot of resistance on the top thigh. Hold it here. Keep pushing the knee into the palm. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Relax. Pull the knee in towards the chest. Maybe you might notice that it can go a little further than where it was last. Hold it here. Each exhalation, hold it here. Each exhalation, actively drawing that right knee in towards the chest. Okay, this whole practice is around. It's important in this particular practice to notice if you feel any pain at any point in time. And if you do, always retract a little bit more, find 60 or 50% effort, or just skip it entirely if it's way too much. From here, slowly release. From here, slowly release. Sending the right foot back down. Okay, the next posture is called thread the needle. So you're gonna start with your left heel on top of your right knee. If you can't interlace the fingers, meaning you can't thread the left arm through the hole and the right arm around the right knee, if this is too much for you, you can always use a strap. So either taking the outside of that knee or shin, or you can strap along this foot and pull it in the same way. So I'm going to show you with a strap. So I like this particular variation, and this is what I normally teach for my classes. I'm going to stay here for about a minute or so. With each exhalation, maybe drawing the knee further in towards the chest. It's okay if it doesn't reach. And actively trying to push this knee out towards the ceiling. No extreme pushing or pulling. One more full breath in. Good. To release, just set the right foot down, unstrap the leg. Good, and let's just switch sides. So right heel on top of the left knee. Okay, either interlace the hands right through or finding a strap, strapping at the foot, the ball of the foot, and just draw that left knee. Now, if you're experiencing a lot of pain, what you can do is to keep the foot flexed. So that creates a protection for your right knee. Taking full breaths in and out. Each exhalation, maybe drawing the knee a little closer in towards the chest. The opposite hand, or rather your right hand, can be used to push this right knee out towards the ceiling as well. Take another full breath in. And a full breath out. Slowly release the strap, setting the left foot down, setting both feet down. Take a moment here. Next, we're going to do a simple hamstring stretch, which is very similar to the test that we did just now. So if your range of motion isn't to bring your leg up to 90 degrees, go ahead, just hold it to a point where you're not experiencing a lot of pain, where while still getting a stretch in your hamstring. So bringing the left leg all the way down, you're welcome to start with the knees bent first and then extend it down. We're going to start stretching the right leg. So extend the left leg. You're going to strap onto the sole of the foot of the right leg. So as I said before, if this is where you're at, then keep it where it is, especially if you're experiencing a lot of pain by bringing the leg all the way up. So same thing, we're going to do the PNF stretching technique. So making sure that the left leg is nice and stable, meaning it's rolling in towards the midline, the foot is flexed. So you don't have to pull too hard, no tensing in the shoulders, no tensing in your jaw. Just relax everything and just hold up the leg. The strap is just there to assist it from falling towards the ground. What you want to do here is to create a lot of resistance by pressing your foot into the strap, and you're resisting by pulling that strap towards your face for a few seconds. For 10, keep pressing into the strap, the sole of the foot into the strap, and the strap is preventing it from falling down. This helps to contract your calves, your quadriceps, your hamstrings. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Relax. Maybe drawing the knee a little closer, the foot a little closer towards the face. Relaxing your shoulders, your jaw. Again, you're welcome to try it a few times if you feel a bigger sense of relief. Another full breath in. The end of that exhalation, slowly release that leg down. You're welcome to bend it here, release the strap. Okay. We'll do it to the other side. Straighten that right leg, draw the left knee in, strap the sole of the foot, and extend it all the way up. Same thing, right leg is nice and active. Pushing the floor away. Pushing the sole of the foot into the strap, creating a lot of resistance. The strap holds it back. Keep pressing the foot into the strap as much as you can. Maybe micro bending in the knee if you need a little bit more strength. Hold it there for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Relax. Good. Stay here. Take another full breath in, and a full breath out. Slowly release the leg, release the strap, just set it aside. Now we're going to do a spinal twist that is a continuation from this particular hamstring stretch. So this is where your bolster will come in handy. We're going to start with the right leg. So bring the right knee in towards your chest. Now again, if this is too much, you might want to hug the bolster in and just take a lighter twist. And if you can, twisting all the way, your right knee can rest on the bolster. Having the right shoulder down, either opening up into cactus arms if you don't have a lot of space, or opening up through the shoulders if you do. The bolster is there to help you in case You feel like it's too much pressure because the knee feels like it's dropping down a lot. And we're gonna stay here for a full minute. At any point in time, as a full minute is too much for you, just come out of it and take a couple of breaths before you go in towards the next stretch. Take a full breath in. Yeah, let's switch sides. Slowly come out. Okay. Straighten the right leg. Pull the left knee in towards your chest and then begin to twist. Same thing. You can always use a bolster. Tip it in between that thigh, left shoulder on the floor, or you can stack it and then try to bring the rest of the knee on top. Okay? Your choice. One more full breath in. At the end of that exhalation, slowly twist all the way out. You can take a few breaths, knocking your knees together, and just reset the spine. Inhale and exhale. One more time, inhale and exhale. Okay. Go ahead, drop to one side, whichever side is convenient, using your top arm to press all the way back up. Good. Okay, so from here, we're gonna start with the lunge position. We'll start with the right leg. So extend your right leg forward. Your left knee is bent and on the mat. Okay, so if this is too much on your knee and you feel like you're bearing a lot of weight, you can always double pad your mat. Another option is to take two blocks by your side. And as you push the weight forward, by pushing the left thigh forward into the mat, you're gonna feel a stretch all the way on that left hip flexor. And you're going to stay here, okay? If you can do it without blocks, you can always place both hands on your knees. As you push the left thigh down, you're leaning the back behind you towards the end of the mat. So you're creating two opposing energies here, which is what's keeping your whole body in this nice state of balance, okay? So as much as you can, as if you're driving this knee forward, okay? Driving the left thigh forward, and at the same time, leaning back so that you're creating that nice balance. Okay. If you're doing it with the blocks, just hold on to the block, same thing, leaning the weight forward, pushing your left thigh forward, and just reaching back at the same time. Take a full breath in. Okay, let's switch sides. Okay, drive the right leg back, left knee forward. Go ahead, pushing that left knee towards the front of your mat, driving the right thigh forward, holding onto your blocks for support, lifting through the chest and bend, slight bend in the back. So Allow yourself to close the eyes and stay here. Breathe. We're only going to stay here for 30 seconds, creating a deep stretch into that hip flexor. One more full breath in. Slowly release. So the next stretch, I'm going to get you to stand on your two feet.
You're going to face a wall. So as much as I can, I'm going to try talking towards the camera instead of towards the wall. So it's very simple. You're going to take one hand, so the opposite hand of the leg that you're stretching for support. So I'm taking the left hand because I'll stretch the right leg first. And again, we're going to incorporate PNF stretching in this one. So you're going to grab onto the sole of the foot. So the left hand is just to help you stay balanced. So as much as you can, you're going to draw the knee out and draw the heel away from the bum as much as you can. So creating a lot of resistance for 10 full seconds. Keep drawing the heel away from the bum, the knee away from the wall. 5, 4, 3, 2, and one, relax. The knee comes closer towards the wall and the heel comes closer towards the bum. Now we're going to stay here. Now if you feel a lot of pressure in the knee, you might not want to hold it for a full minute or a full 30 seconds. Hold it for a few 10 to 15 seconds and that might be enough for you. Take a full breath in. Go ahead, release this leg. Same thing on the other side. Right hand holds onto the wall. Bending into that left knee, grabbing onto the heel. Let's create resistance, pushing the heel away from the bum, the knee away from the midline, So we're going to create resistance by pushing the heel away from the bum, knee away from the wall. For 10, 9, keep pushing, 8, really feeling the weight of that leg in towards that hand, 4, 3, 2, and 1, relax, drawing the heel towards the bum, the knee back in towards the wall. Each exhalation may be drawing the heel closer and closer towards the bum. Relax, no pushing, no pulling, no extreme pushing or pulling. Take a full breath in. One last breath in. Exhale. Good. Slowly release that leg. Don't slingshot. Good. Maybe shake out your legs if you need to. So the next stretch is quite an intense hip opener. If it's too much for you, you can skip this completely. So this is the pigeon. So I'm going to show a variation instead of putting typically, okay, so we're going to start on the right side. Actually, we'll start on the left side so I can show you where the block is. So typically, a lot of people like to put the block on the outer left hip, so right under, so that you can really sit on it. What I find really useful is instead to keep the hip square, instead of doing that, what you can do is to place the block right on your upper right thigh, so the opposite thigh. So if your leg doesn't come to 90 degrees, don't worry about it. The heel can drop closer in towards the groin. Come all the way down. If you can do forearms, go ahead. If not, just use a block or a bolster to support you. Rotating yourself such that the weight is evenly distributed to both sides. And then you can close your eyes. Maybe if you can, even rest your head all the way down if it's possible. And stay here for just a full minute. Breathing in and out through the nose. Every exhalation, making sure the hips are square and the weight is evenly distributed throughout the body. Let's take a full breath in together. Inhale. And exhale, release. Let's switch sides. Slowly find your way out. Okay. A nice way to release is to roll onto that left outer hip just for a second to release the block on the right thigh. Stay here for maybe 10 seconds or so. And then let's switch sides. Come back into tabletop. I find that that's the easiest way to come in and out. Same thing, lock underneath that left thigh. Okay. Find what's comfortable for you. And then lower down to forearms. Option is to take a block. And you can rest the forearms on the block as well. This is also another option. Just again, same thing, making sure the weight is evenly distributed. Lower the head down and just relax here. Take a full breath in. And a full breath out. The end of that exhalation, slowly find your way out. Okay. And same thing, roll over to that right side, release. Slowly take out that left, the block on that left leg. And then bring the leg forward. Okay. So from here, we have a few more stretches to go. You're going to find yourself on a wall. It's very important to find your back on the wall for support. This one is actually quite fun. Okay, so you're going to find your way, your back onto the wall. You have to be able to wiggle your bum so close to the wall that you feel your entire lower back, your mid back, and your upper back entirely supported by the wall. So I definitely recommend sitting in Dandasana. This is called staff pose with the wall support. If you are reading or if you're doing stuff on the computer, anything that you generally would do seated on a chair or on a couch, take this particular seating posture if you do have a habit of sacrificing it. When you're sacrificing your posture, when you're seated on your couch or on your bed or at your desk. So I did this with my father-in-law, and this has been very helpful to him. In fact, he felt a lot of pain relief just by sitting here while he was reading or while he was doing his work. So definitely recommend this. Okay, so before we do staff pose, we're going to sit and point and flex the toes. We're going to do half gomukhasana, so half cow. So with the back on the wall, you're going to take your left knee over the right. Now again, if this is already too much for you and you're already feeling the left outer hip, you can always stack a block and just support it in such a way that you still feel a light stretch on the left outer hip.
without creating too much pressure, that you feel pain in the knee and it's pinching pain all the way at the bottom. Okay. So if you're doing it without the block, left knee over the right, keeping the right foot flexed at all times and just staying here. You can just rest your hands on top of the thighs. Take a full breath in. Okay, let's switch sides. So left leg extends out, right knee on top. Use a block if you need to. So stay here. Take a full breath in, and a full breath out. Okay, slowly release. And we're gonna come sit into staff pose. Adjust yourself so that your whole back is supported on the wall. So just by sitting like this with your feet flexed is enough. If this is a lot for you, you already feel the length in your legs, go ahead, just stay here. The other option is to just point and hold it for about 5 seconds and then flex the feet. Hold it for about 10 seconds. Good. Inhale, point. Hold for about 5 seconds. And exhale, flex for another 10. Inhale, point. And exhale, flex. Last one, inhale, point. And exhale, flex. Good, slowly relax. Keeping the toes slightly, feet slightly flexed, and just rest here. Stay here for about a minute, maybe rest the head down, head towards the wall. Take a full breath in. Good. You're going to come into butterfly feet, so Baddha Konasana. Your back is still flat against the wall. Now if this is too much for you, just grab onto two blocks and you're just going to slide them under your knees and stay here. Okay, so you can always push out the heels away from your face to release the stretch, or unless it feels comfortable, draw it in closer towards your groin. Okay, so if it's too much, just use the blocks. Okay, so I'm gonna use the blocks for this particular video, and we're just gonna breathe in and out for about a minute. So again, the sequence is really nice if you're just winding down and looking to get a little bit of movement before bed. You don't want anything dynamic because it's going to make your heart rate go up and it's going to make your mind very energetic. And I often find that hot yoga or dynamic vinyasa yoga at the end of the day creates so much energy for me that I find it difficult to sleep at night. So having something simple like this where you're mostly on the ground, and you're working with your legs to stimulate relaxation throughout the whole body. You're welcome to stay here for as long as you want. If you want to meditate, sit in seated meditation. Taking a full breath in. To come out, all you have to do is to take the hands, scoop up the knees, and set the blocks aside, and we're going to come into final rest. So you're welcome to skip this entirely, only because we haven't really been moving out around a lot. So if you're happy to go straight to bed, go ahead. Yeah, otherwise, you're going to lie all the way down. You're going to have your bolster right on the underside of your knees. Okay, this helps to create it helps to create support for the lower back as you are lying down. Open up your hands nice and wide. You can break all the rules of Shavasana, so you don't have to have the hands down here. You can have them out by the sides. Just close your eyes. Let's take a full breath in together. Inhale. And exhale. Relaxing your whole body. Just allow yourself to pause the video and just stay here for as long as you want. And thank you so much for watching today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it. As always, questions, recommendations, or suggestions, or comments, feel free to leave them down below or drop me a message. I actually posted the same static sequence in photo form on Instagram, so be sure to check that out. And thank you. Have a good day ahead of you. Bye.